It's like you told me, go for it slowly. It's not a race till the end. Well, you look like yourself, but you're somebody else, only it ain't on the surface. Well, you talk like yourself, no, I hear someone.
All right, welcome back to Morning Coffee with Rick Alexander. Today, I want to talk about my favorite thing in the entire world, and that is growth. Personal growth, professional growth, and growth in any way. I'm addicted to it. It's a value of mine. I always like to make sure that I'm growing. And in fact, I left the military because I felt like I was in a position where I was no longer growing. And that sometimes you got to make uncomfortable decisions in order to live up and be true to your values. And so that's what I did. The reason I'm going to bring it up today, though, is because I think anybody that listens to this is going to be growth-minded in some way, shape, or form. But I think that something you really need to think about, and I don't think that we think about this enough in our everyday lives, is the environment that we're trying to grow in. See, we can be growth-minded. We can do all the things that we have to do. But if the environment is not conducive to growth, well, then it's all going to be for naught. You know, and this is consistent throughout nature, right? This isn't a human thing. We can look at all these different species and realize that growth is completely dependent upon the environment. The most obvious example that just comes to mind is if you put a goldfish in a tank and it will grow if you put it in a bigger tank. Like, everybody knows that. The tree line, that's another thing you can look at. It's like trees don't grow above a certain elevation, and that is due to temperature, it's due to moisture, it's due to oxygen in the air, and there's all these different factors, right? Like, I remember growing up in New England, you get in New Hampshire and like above 4,500 feet is like the tree line, and after that, a tree can't grow because the environment isn't conducive to growth. And so you have these trees that are super short and stunted. And I wonder how many of us are walking around our lives super short and stunted because we are in an environment that isn't conducive to where we actually want to be. And again, like, it's not on the tree, but it's on the environment. It could be that you're just not in a place to grow, you know, in your own life. Like, I think about this all the time. Like, if I'm the smartest person in the room or the most capable person in the room, the strongest person in the room, I look for a new room. And the reason being because I know that I'm not in an environment that's going to set me up to grow to my fullest potential. And if that's something that you value, then you really have to be careful about ensuring that your environment is set up to live up to your values. And that is, that is the case for all of your values, really. I'm talking about growth because that's one of my biggest values. And I know most people that listen to this show are growth-minded. But if honesty is one of your values and you're in a relationship that lacks serious honesty, like, it might be time to change your environment. And, you know, sometimes what we find is we get in certain situations and there are personality traits that we don't like and they end up getting pulled out of us, and that's because of the environment, right? It's like you want to be with somebody romantically that makes you a better person. But if you're with somebody that is forcing you to compromise your values, or even if you show up in a way, like, you know, I've noticed this, like, sometimes there's certain people that I'm around, like, let's say maybe in my hometown, and I show up in a way that I don't like. It's different. I don't know if I'm like, if it's ego and I'm trying to like prove myself in a certain way. I don't really know. But what I do know is that that environment isn't set up for me to be completely content with myself and to live out my values. And so I would say, as you think about your own goals, the things that you want to accomplish in life, think about just purely from an environmental standpoint. Pretend right now that you're doing everything in your power to get to these goals. Pretend that you're checking the boxes, you've created a plan of action, you're moving through it. But think about your environment. Is your environment set up to get you to that end state that you're looking for, to get you to that growth, to get you to that goal, to help you cross through structural tension? Or every time you make contact with that environment, are you sort of folding inward? Are you lessening who you really are? Are you not stepping into your full self, your full potential? And it's only because of the environment, because the people around you. Maybe if you know that if you speak up in a certain way about what you want, that others are going to cut you down right away or try to take wind out of your sails. Like, I've got friends like that, right? And I don't even think that they mean to. It's like you've got these friends that are kind of always putting you down in a very backhanded, slight way. And you kind of pick up on it. Like, I've started, you know, getting rid of those people in my life, and I don't think it's their fault. And maybe it's something you want to have that crucial conversation. Bring it up. Like, hey, every time I'm around you and I talk about this, I talk about this thing I want to do, like, you always have something negative to say about it, or you try to make fun of me in like a sarcastic kind of way. Like, I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I've got those kind of friends, and I really like have realized that that environment is not conducive to my growth. And look, if you've got values that you want to live up to in this lifetime, it's too damn short to be fighting with your environment and fighting for yourself and your goals. Like, fighting for yourself and your goals and the life that you want is hard enough. It really is. Like, there's so much adversity that you're going to encounter just by nature of who you are and the thing that you're trying to do in life, especially if what you're trying to do is great. You know, and I'd imagine it is great in whatever perspective that is. Not maybe it's not something that's going to be this like life changing thing, but maybe you want to be like a great parent. And every time you get around your parents, they cut you down in front of your kids. Like, there are so many different ways that this can manifest. And so I would encourage you right now to think about your goals, and then just think about the fact that whether or not your environment is set up so that you'll actually reach those goals. You know, or if the environment is set up to keep you in your place, because a lot of times, and this is the case with friends that are going to cut you down, they're more comfortable with you in your place, straight up. And so they don't want you to grow out of that environment. So you might have to move yourself into a different environment to get where you want to get. Again, a lot of this is happening on subconscious levels. We're not always aware of it. Our friends that are cutting us down might not be aware of it. They might silently or quietly resent you for your growth or your thing, or who knows, maybe you screwed them over in the past and they haven't let that go. Like, there's so many different reasons, but at the end of the day, it doesn't necessarily matter. What matters is your environment is either set up so that you can grow into the best possible version of you, or it's not. And if it's not, you're going to have a really hard time getting where you want to go, because you're not only fighting the adversity of doing something difficult, but you're also fighting the environment. And you know, when you look at nature, the way that things show up and grow, it's so dependent on their environment. Like the tree example that I gave in New Hampshire, the tree line is like 4,500 feet. Out here in Colorado, the environment is different. The snow line is different. The moisture is different. And so the tree line's like way up around 10,000 feet. So don't stay in New England at 4,500 feet if 10,000 feet's where you want to be. Like, you're not under any obligation to stay in the environment that you're in, or to stunt your growth, or to have less of a life to make the people around you comfortable. So really think about that. Really think about the environment that you're putting yourself in, because it really is such a game changer. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later on Morning Coffee.
The lights go out, I am all alone. All the trees outside are buried in the snow. I spend my night dancing with my own shadow, and it holds me and it never lets me go. I move slow and steady, but I feel like a waterfall. Yeah, I move slow and steady.